Hi, welcome to my channel. My name is Monique and my channel is called Dutch Monique. And yes, that is because I am from the Netherlands. Today I have for you the review of the Pat McGrath Mothership 7 Divine Rose. As you know, if you have seen that video, of course, then you have seen that I have received this for testing because I am a member of the Douglas test team and they sent me this palette to test. And I had made photos with several looks of it to share on my Instagram account, and the photos are gone. I think I have deleted them by mistake. Yeah. Not so good. No. But nevertheless, the video is still here and I have to review. Now I give you my thoughts about this eyeshadow palette. The eyeshadow palette, it is beautiful. The size, the packaging, it screams luxury. It really screams luxury. There's a beautiful mirror inside. And the color story is also very, very beautiful. It's very neutral. You can do anything. You can make a glam look and you can make an everyday look. Everything is possible with this eyeshadow palette. I must confess, it is. Everything is possible. You can do an easy all day makeup or just a glam makeup when you're going out to a party or something like that. Yes, we can party again. The colors are nice, the mattes do blend really, really nice. There's hardly any fallout, only one color has fallout, and that was this one here. And that color is called Astral Saltis. It's a beautiful palette. What can I say? I really am impressed about the quality, but I also have another palette from Pat McGrath, so I was familiar with the formula. I knew what to accept, and the consistency of that palette is the same as in this palette, or this palette, it is the same as the other palette. So it's beautiful. My favorite color, and that's the one I use the most, is this orange one. And when you swatch it, it has a pink, maybe you can see it now, you see it turn into pink and then orange. It is the most beautiful eyeshadow color I have ever seen, and my husband is saying something to me, but the door is closed, so I have to answer. One moment. So there I am again. Where were we? Oh yes, the most beautiful color. It is peachy and it switch into pink, and it is really, really beautiful. I love that color. That color is really the favorite of this eyeshadow palette for me. So yeah, great palette, love it, will you use it? Yes, of course, it is fantastic. Is this the best I have ever used? No. I must say, there is quite a price tag on this eyeshadow palette. And the quality is there. Don't get me wrong. The quality is there and the colors are insane. But I must say, I prefer the formulation of Natasha Denona, the big palette. Yes, I know what I'm saying. Is it comparable? Well, you get more colors with Natasha Denona for the same price tag. And yeah, Pat McGrath isn't bad. No, it's not. Please understand me correctly. I'm not saying that it is a bad palette. It is an amazing palette and I am very pleased with it. But deep in my heart, if I have to choose between a palette of Natasha Denona and a palette of Pat McGrath, I will choose the one from Natasha Denona. That's all I wanted to say. My preference is a little bit more towards Natasha. So that is why this beautiful palette of Natasha Denona is the next one in my bi-week eyeshadow palette project. It's a mouthful. I always have to think how to speak it out loud. Bi-week eyeshadow palette project. A lot of peace. Yes, that. So this will be the palette. It's the Zendo palette. I've received this one from my husband for my birthday last August. And this is how she looks. Oh, I think she... The packaging is beautiful. It is amazing. Also a nice big mirror inside. And these are the colors. Well, aren't they beautiful? Yes, they are. They are amazing. So, 15 colors. I will swatch them for you, of course. And we will be using this eyeshadow palette. Don't you know what my project is? Didn't I say that? Well, let me explain something to you. We all have the same problem. We have several eyeshadow palettes, but we always seem to grab the same one. Mm-hmm. Yes. Guilty, huh? Yes, you are. So, I was also like that. But I wanted to change that because I have so much eyeshadow palettes. And they are all beautiful. And it's a waste if it's just lying there in the drawer. Or wherever you keep your palettes. It's a waste. And they all need our love. All our eyeshadow palettes need our love. So I thought, well, let's do an eyeshadow palette project. That means that for every 14 days, I will be using one eyeshadow palette. I'll pick one eyeshadow palette. And so all the palettes are circulating. And then I make several eye looks with them during those 14 days. I will take pictures. If I don't erase the pictures, I will take pictures of them and I'll show that to you on my Instagram account. So follow me on my Instagram account. It is Monique67, Dutch Monique67. You can see then the eye looks that I have created with the particular eyeshadow palette that I am using. Yeah, so that is the deal. So I will swatch this for you. Well, my arm. And I will go like this. I will start here at the top and I will go like that from right to left. The first color is Mindful. And that is a beautiful brown. Then we have Luster, it's there. I'm not the best in swatching, but I will try. Let's grab a tissue to clean my fingers because I don't want that there is everywhere. I don't want one color transferred to another. The second color is Balance. And the third color. And the fourth color is Flow. And Flow, yeah. I like Flow. Yes, that's the teal. Love that color. And then the last color of the first row is called Mantra. And Mantra is a beautiful green. Okay, this is the first row. Then let's clean my fingers. The second row, we will start with Aura and Vigor. aura and vigor. Vigor didn't swatch very well. But no, it's okay. It's okay. Then we have relief. And I don't know if I pronounce this right. Equilibrium. 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 Don't know how to pronounce that. This is that equilibrium. Really can't pronounce that word. And then the last color of this row is breath. And it's a light green. Okay, the last row. Last row. First one is sense. And then we have tranquil. It's the second color. Ooh, I love those two. This is sense and tranquil. Then we have calm, yama, calm. Oh, I like that also. And yama. These two are comparable with each other, but one is shimmer and one is matte. Although in the palette they don't look the same. And the last color is zeal. And that is zeal. So this is the color story of the Natasha Denona Zendo palette. Let's remove these swatches. And then I will make an eye look. I will do one eye on camera, the second eye I will do off camera. And then I will, at the end, I will give you my thoughts and my opinion of the palette. My first thoughts. I've only used this palette once, so... Well, let's take a nip of my tea, and then we will start. I will bring you in a little bit closer. Let's grab some brushes. I want that one, I want that one. I want that one, maybe that one. One, two, three, yeah, maybe that one. So, and I will start with a transition color. I will bring you a little bit closer to me, so you can see what I will be doing. And now my nose is itching, always at the wrong moment. Okay, I have my mirror here. I will start with... I want to use that color, or shall I go for the blue? Difficult decisions, they are hard to make. I will start with relief. It's this one here. Because this is such a beautiful palette, I don't know where to start. Do you have that problem, that you have a new eyeshadow palette? When I have a new eyeshadow palette, at first I don't want to swatch it because I want to keep it just the way it is. Yes, I know, I'm crazy. And then, when I'm starting to use it, then I am sometimes overwhelmed. I don't know what to start with. And well, I'm so excited to use it, but then, yeah, I don't know what to do. But it will come alright. It will be alright. So first, let's start with this color in the crease. Well, I apply it above, just above the crease, as a transition color. I make circular movements. so it blends out really well. And I am using my Zoeva brush, and I just saw a little fly pass here. I hate flies, those really big ones. I think they are disgusting. But this was just a little one you see when you have fruit laying around. In the Netherlands we call that fruitvliegjes. The exact translation is fruit flies. Well, and I think this blends out really, really nice. And I have used the Zoeva 221 Luxe Soft Grease. I love that, yeah. This blends out really, really nice. That is great, yes. Okay, well, let's do the other eye. Let's do that at the same time. Last week I was very, very upset. Well, upset. I was angry. I was so angry. My parents asked what I want for Christmas. Yes, they are early, but that is because they have $2, my sister and I, our husbands, and then we both have children. Well, at least I have one child, a daughter, but my sister has two sons and one daughter. And almost everybody of my nieces and nephews, only one nephew doesn't have a girlfriend yet, but my other nephew has a girlfriend and my niece has a boyfriend and my daughter has a boyfriend, and we all celebrate Christmas together. That's a tradition. On the 25th of December we all go to my parents' house and then we drink coffee, tea and eat cake or chocolate or something like that, and we talk and we laugh and well, and then we go, yeah, then we eat. Then my father and my sister and I are going into the kitchen, and the boys and the girls are setting the table, and well, it's like one big Italian family. We're not Italian, but it is just one big family, and we love those days. Then before dinner, no, first we drink coffee and tea, and then before we start with the dinner, we exchange gifts. So my parents have to buy a lot of gifts, of course, for my sister and I, and for my sister and me, and then our husbands, the children, the friends of the children. So yeah, they are starting early with buying those presents. And she asked, what do you want? And then I saw that Reffer, those brushes, you know, those expensive brushes, they had a sale. Yes. So I ordered some brushes. I think it was half price or 40% off. It was a really good deal. So I ordered some brushes. Well, you get Track and Trace, of course. And finally, the day was there. The Track and Trace said, your package is on his way with the chauffeur, with the delivery guy, and you received it today. Well, a lot happened today, but no delivery guy. So I checked my Track and Trace, because sometimes it is delayed and you get it the next day. They've changed then the moment that they deliver it. And I saw that it had the package, the number, has got the label, couldn't deliver it. it's been turned back to sender. And I was like, what? Returning it to sender? No, 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 no way. So I called DHL. And I asked them, what is the matter? What's the matter with my package? Why isn't it delivered? She couldn't tell me that, but she could see that it is returned to sender. So annoying. So I emailed Refer, and I must say, they react the same day. And I've told them the problem that I have, and they say, don't worry, we'll send you a new one. So my new package is on his way. For some reason, DHL couldn't return the fact that they are returning my package back to sender. So, don't know why that is, but there is a new package on his way. So that is nice, and I think I will start with the color. I want that one. Yeah. I want that one. That is beautiful. So yes, I was really mad. You can imagine that. So now I am still waiting on my brushes. I should have had them, I should have had them for a few days now, but well, there are new package is on his way, and don't know where the first package is. It's somewhere. Probably think they just lost it. They just lost my package. How that is possible, I don't know. Well, as you all know, I always, the color that I apply in the outer V, I always use a reference point. That is the, when my eye is open here, the highest point, then I'll go in a straight line, and that is where I want my eyeshadow to end. And as you can see, that is the case now. So if you go from here in a straight line, then you end there. So that. Usually I blend it out in the crease. That is a possibility, but I'm not doing that this time. And if you think, well, it is very light, the swatch was deeper, you are right, but I am using a light hand now because I don't want it to be too hard here in the corner. I can always build it up, and I think I need to build it up because in this eye is darker than here. So, and I always go upwards, because if you have mature skin, you better go, it's better for you to go upwards. Like that. So see if it is same. Sometimes it's different. Don't know why, but I think they are quite the same now. This is more. This looks like a blood, and this is more a V than this eye. Don't know why that is. So, yeah, that is better. Okay, yeah. Then, I will grab the color Flow. That's this light teal, and I'll apply that on the eyelid. And for that I will be using my Zoeva Luxe Soft Definer. And I'll apply that on the lid. Oh, I love this. This is beautiful. Right here in the corner. And I'll do it in the crease, this color. And here where it's meeting the dark color that I can't pronounce, I am wiggling so it makes a smooth transfer to one in another color. So okay, and I feel something itching here. It's gone. Okay, next eye. I apply that all over the lid, up to the crease in the corner here, and then wiggle it here so that it transfers even. So okay, ooh, love this. Yeah, okay, I'll go back with the first brush I've used. That was the 221 Luxe Soft Grease, and then I'll blend here the quite a hard line here yet. I'll blend that and make that a little bit softer. I haven't applied any products on the brush, just using what is left on the brush to make those edges a little bit softer. Yes, okay. Okay then. Well, then we go on the lower lash line. For the lower lash line, I'm using this brush. It is from the Douglas, and it's a 4-4 rounded eyeshadow brush. It's a really small one, so you can go easy underneath there. And I will use the color Flow, so the color that I've used on the eyelid. I'll use that one. To connect and to make it one beautiful look. And this is, I do love this color. This is probably my favorite color of the whole eyeshadow palette. I think it is. It is so amazing. I like it. I hope you can see what I am doing. I am always afraid that the mirror that I'm using is in front of the lens, so you don't see anything that I'm doing. Well, that is really something I always scared of. I love this. I think this is amazing. Oh, I do love the formula of Natasha Denona. Then here in the corner, I want something in the corner, and I think I will use I love that Tranquil. That's this color here. I will use that as a highlighter in the corner. I will use the same brush which I've used for underneath the eye. What was I saying? Tranquil. It gives a certain freshness to the look. I do love a pop of color in the corner of the eye. And a little bit I'm blending it out a little bit underneath the eye. So, yeah, have it. I think that this is the look for today. Yeah. Love it, like it. Okay, I will apply the rest of my makeup on. I'll be right back. Bye. Well, I'm back. Just had to apply some mascara on and some lipstick, because everything else that was already on my face, the eyeshadow palette, my thoughts, well, it is amazing. I love it. The colors are speaking to me. I can make so much eye looks with this. I think it is a really stunning eyeshadow palette. So, if you're interested to see more eyeshadow looks, follow me on Instagram. I think it's beautiful. This teal and this blue, or yeah, it's a dark teal. Equilibrium. Yeah, I think that's how you pronounce it. It is amazing. It is so beautiful. I love it. The lipstick I'm using is from Dior. Also amazing. Never had a lipstick from Dior. Well, from Chanel, but not from Dior. Received this one from one of my subscribers, from Tove. And it is beautiful. I think it matches really, really well with the eye look. I want a color day. Yeah, I think let's do a little bit of color for today. So, bright eyes, bright lips. Usually when I do bright lips, I have a subtle eye look, or vice versa. When I have a bright eye look, I do a subtle lipstick. But now I want to do both, because I can. Well, what do you think of the eye look? Do you like it? What are your thoughts? This is the palette that I will be using for the next 14 days. Follow me on Instagram and leave your comment down below. Like this video. And if you are not subscribed yet to my video, to my YouTube channel, please do join my great, great family. I love you all. And I like to chat with you all. I always try to interconnect with you. But sometimes life gets in the way, and then I just like your message. But I am intending to always answer you back. But sometimes life gets in the way, and I don't have the time for that then. Okay, stay safe. See you the next time, and be kind to each other. Bye.